of interest on drawing. Okay, dear children. So here are some, there are some basics of interest on drawing, some provisions which required to calculate interest on drawing. So I will explain 2-3 questions so you can easily solve these questions. So let's start from question number 36. Fine. Ram and Mohan, two partners, drew for their personal use 1,20,000 and 80,000. Interest is chargeable at the rate of 6% per annum on the drawings. What is the amount of interest chargeable from each partner? Dear children, in this question, date of drawing is not given. And when date of drawing is not given, it is computed on an average basis, that is 6 monthly. Remember this point. So in this question, how to calculate interest on drawing? Interest on drawing when date of drawing is not given. Date of drawing is not given. Dear children, remember, when date of drawing is not given, it is computed for average basis, that is for 6 monthly. Remember, always remember, right? This is the point in this question. So the name of partners are Ram Mohan, 1,20,000, 80,000 are their drawing, and the rate of interest which is given, that is 6% per annum. 6% means 6 by 100, but we will calculate for 6 monthly. Why for 6 monthly? Because date of drawing is not given, remember, dear children. So when date of drawing is not given, it is computed only for 6 monthly on an average basis. So let's calculate 1,20,000 multiply by 6%, 7,200, 6 by 12, 3,600. 80,000, 8, 6, 48, it's the half, 2,400. I hope this concept is clear to everyone. Is that clear? So let's see another question, one more question of interest on drawing. Question number 37. These are very basic questions, dear children. Very, very basic questions, but useful questions. 37. Bridge and Mohan are partners in a firm. Bridge and Mohan are partners in a firm. They withdrew 48,000 and 36,000 respectively. 48,000, 36,000 respectively. During the year, evenly, in the middle of every month. Remember. According to the partnership deed, interest on drawing is to be charged 10% per annum. Dear children, interest on drawing is 12% per annum. Fine. Sorry, 10%. 10% per annum. Calculate interest on drawing of the partners using the appropriate formula. When the similar amount is withdrawn at regular interval, there is one formula of calculation of interest on drawing. What is the formula? The formula of average period basis is time left after first drawing plus time left after last drawing divide by 2. So in this question, dear children, Brij and Mohan both withdrew in the middle of every month. Tell me time left after first drawing. What will be the time left after first drawing?
11.5.
Correct. Because it means the first drawing will be made on 15th April, isn't it? If they are withdrawing in the mid of every month. So on 15th April, if first drawing is made, it means from 15th April, if we calculate, so 11.5 months are left. Time left after first drawing. Plus, time left after last drawing.
0.5.
Because last drawing will be done on 15th March, if they are withdrawing on the mid of every month. So how, let us do the total. 11.5 plus 0.5, 12 divided by 2, it means 6. So we need to calculate for 6 months for both the partners. So this is the way how do we calculate interest on drawing on the basis of average period basis method. Of average period basis method. And this method is only used when equal amount is withdrawn at equal intervals, regular intervals. Okay, so let's calculate for Brij and Mohan. Brij, 48,000 multiply by rate of interest on drawing is 10% and multiply by 6 by 12. We have computed 6 month here in this manner. And we need to calculate for Mohan also. The drawing of Mohan is 36,000. 36,000 multiply by 10% for 6 months. Okay. So 48,000 ka 10%, 4800 ka half, 2400. 36,000 10%, 3600. 3600 ka half, 1800. I hope this question is clear to everyone. Hai na simple? Okay, so let's move on. Next question, question number 38. Question number 38 was the part of CBSE 2019 paper, dear children. So question number 38. Dev withdrew rupees 10,000 on the 15th day of every month. It means at the mid of every month. Interest on drawing was to be charged at the rate of 12% per annum. Can you calculate interest on Dev's drawing? Yes, we can calculate. Interest on drawing. How much he withdrew? 10,000 on 15th day of every month. So there are 12 months in a year. So 10,000 into 12, it means 1,20,000. 1,20,000. Multiply by what is the rate? The rate is given 12% per annum. So 12% per annum means 12 by 100. And he withdrew on 15th of every month. Means 11.5 month, time left after first drawing, time left after last drawing, divide by 2. How many month comes? 6 month comes. So it means we need to calculate for 6 month. Is that clear? 1,20,000 into 12% and divide by 2. 7,200 is the interest on drawing of Dev. I hope it is clear to everyone. Clear or not? Then it will be easy for all of you. A different point is given here in this question. So it is better, let me explain. A and B are partners sharing profits equally. A and B are sharing profits equally. Fine. He drew regularly 4,000 in the beginning of every month for 6 months. So 4,000 for 6 months, A drew. So 4, 6, 24,000 he withdrew. A. Ended 30th September 2019. Calculate interest on drawing at the rate of 5% per annum. Interest on drawing is 5% per annum. So dear children, when he withdrew, in the beginning, isn't it? So we need to compute date from the beginning of every month. So again, let's use that formula. Time left after first drawing. How much time is left? 6 months, yes or no? 6 months left, na? Because first drawing will be made on 1st April to 30 September. Then time left after last drawing, 1 month. So in this manner, if we divide by 2, now what we get? 6 plus 1, 7 divided by 2, 3.5 month. It means we need to calculate for 3.5 month interest on drawing. So let us calculate interest on drawing for A. So 24,000 multiplied by rate of interest is 5%. 5% means 5 by 100 into 3.5. Now 3.5 by 6 or 12? It will be 3.5 divided by 12. Okay? So this is how we compute. This is written 5% per annum. Per annum means per year. So that's why we always calculate per annum 3.5 month by 12. In this manner we need to compute. So let's compute for it. So 24,000 multiplied by 5% into 3.5, so 350 is coming. So 350 is the correct answer. I hope you all got the question clearly. Is that clear, dear children? 39. Let's see another question. Question number 40. These are very simple questions but clear so many doubts in complete questions. Question number 40. One of the partners in a partnership firm has withdrawn 9,000 at the end of each quarter. 9,000 at the end of each quarter throughout the year. Calculate interest on drawing at the rate of 6% per annum. So 9,000 is withdrawn at the end of each quarter. What do you mean by quarter? Do you know?
3 months.
3 months.
How many quarters we have?
Four.
Suppose, now pay attention everyone. This is what I am preparing. Very simple technique in examination. Any type of question can come. Na? You can easily understand. This is 1 year. 1 year starts from 1st April to 31st March. Now end of each quarter. So quarter means four part. Quarter means four part. You can see here. Is that clear? So this is 1 year, current year, and these are the four part. So this is 1st April. After 3 months, what will come?
1st July.
1st July. After 3 months, what will come?
October 1st.
1st October. After 3 months?
January.
January.
After 3 months, this will come, na? Is that clear? So these are four quarter: quarter 1, quarter 2, quarter 3, and quarter 4. So if 9,000 is withdrawn at the end of each quarter, tell me when first drawing is done. On which date?
1st July.
How many months are left?
9.
Is that clear to everyone? So in this manner, you can easily calculate. So 9 months are left after first drawing. 9 month plus. Now when last drawing is done, it means first
31st March.
Yes, correct. So zero months are left, isn't it? So 9 month divided by 2, 4.5 month. We need to calculate interest on drawing for 4.5 month. If 9,000 is withdrawn at the end of each quarter, in 4 quarter, what will be the total amount which is withdrawn?
36,000.
Multiply by what is the rate which is given in this question? 6% per annum. So 6% per annum is given. Na? That's why we need to calculate for 4.5 by 12 interest on drawing. I hope this is clear to everyone. Let's calculate 36,000 multiply by 6% into 4.5 by 12. It is coming 810. I think it is clear to everyone. Anna, dear children, easy, Anna. But this is very simple. These are very simple questions, basic questions, Anna. कोई बड़ा क्वेश्चन आएगा ना तो आपको बहुत हेल्प मिल जाएगी. ये छोटे छोटे जो क्वेश्चन हैं, दीज आर वेरी वेरी हेल्पफुल. लेट्स सॉल्व वन मोर क्वेश्चन, देन वी विल यस लेट्स स्टार्ट वन मोर क्वेश्चन नंबर 41. A and B are partners sharing profits equally. ठीक है. A and B are partners sharing profits equally. A drew regularly 4,000 at the end of every month. Same question. 6 month. No, not. It is given here each quarter. Huh? 4,000 at the end of every month. So A withdrew 4,000 at the end of every month for 6 month, and at 30th September 19 calculate interest on drawing 5% per annum for 6 month. Interest on drawing 5% per annum for 6 month we need to calculate. So he is drawing 4,000 at the end of each month. So tell me time left after first drawing. 5 months. Yes or no? We need to calculate for 6 months means up to 30th September 2019. So we will calculate up to 30th September 2019. So how much time is left after first drawing up to 30th September? 5 months. Isn't it? Then time left after last drawing 0 month divide by 2, so it will be 2.5 month. It means we need to calculate interest on drawing for 2.5 month. He has withdrawn 4,000 for 6 month. 4 6 year 24,000. Rate of interest 5% for 2.5 month divide by 12. Why? Because 5% per annum word is mentioned. So let's calculate 24,000 into 5% into 2.5 by 12. It means 250 rupees. I hope it is clear to everyone. Yes, dear children, is it clear? Question number 43. Kanika and Gautam are partners doing a drying cleaning business in Lucknow. Kanika and Gautam. Sharing profits in the ratio 2:1. With capitals 5 lakh and 4 lakh respectively. Kanika withdrew the following amounts during the year to pay the hostel expenses of her सन. यू कैन सी ऑन 1 अप्रैल 10,000, 1 जून 9,000, 1 नवंबर 14 एंड 1 दिसंबर 5. सो अमाउंट इज नॉट यूनिफॉर्म फर्स्ट थिंग, एंड सेकेंड थिंग द डेट इज ऑल्सो नॉट यूनिफॉर्म. सो वी कैनॉट यूज दैट मैथड विच वी वर यूजिंग एवरेज पीरियड बेसिस मैथड. सो वॉट टू डू वी विल सी. गौतम विड्रू रुपीज 15,000 ऑन फर्स्ट डे ऑफ अप्रैल, जुलाई, अक्टूबर एंड जनवरी टू पे रेंट फॉर द एकोमोडेशन ऑफ हिज फैमिली. ही ऑल्सो पेड 20,000 पर मंथ एज रेंट फॉर ऑफिस ऑफ पार्टनरशिप विच वॉज इन अ नियर बाय शॉपिंग कॉम्प्लेक्स. कैलकुलेट इंटरेस्ट ऑन ड्रॉइंग एट द रेट ऑफ 6% पर एनम. सो इन गौतम्स केस डियर चिल्ड्रन इक्वल अमाउंट इज गिवन, इजंट इट? एंड टाइम इंटरवल इज ऑल्सो यूनिफॉर्म, अप्रैल, जुलाई, अक्टूबर, जनवरी. सो वी कैन कंप्यूट बाय एवरेज पीरियड. बट इन केस ऑफ कनिका वी विल यूज प्रोडक्ट मेथड. सो हाउ टू यूज प्रोडक्ट मेथड, लेट अस सी इन दिस क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 43. इंटरेस्ट ऑन ड्रॉइंग. ओके, बाय यूजिंग प्रोडक्ट मेथड. So first date is given. So what we write? Date on 1 April 10,000. 1 April, how much amount is withdrawn? 10,000. First June 9,000. 1st November 14, 14, okay, and then 1st December 5,000. Now what we need to do, we need to multiply this amount with time left. Time left, okay. If drawing is made on 1st April, tell me how many months are left up to 31st?
12
months are left. Is that clear?
12 months.
Yes. If we have withdrawn on 1st June, tell me how many months are left?
10.
10 months.
10 months are left. Very good. If we have withdrawn on 1st November, how many months are left?
5.
And if we have withdrawn on 1st December, how many months are left?
4.
So we need to multiply the drawing with the time left. Whatever we get, that is known as product. That's why the name of this method is product method. 10 into 12, 1,20,000. 9 10 ja, 90,000. 14 5 ja, 70,000. 5 4 ja, 20,000. And then we need to do the total. So 1,20,000 plus 90,000 plus 70 plus 20 again 90. So it is coming 3 lakh. Total is 3 lakh rupees. Okay. Now we need to compute interest on drawing of Kanika. Kanika's interest on drawing. It is very, very simple. 3 lakh multiply by what is the rate which is given?
6%.
6% per annum. Yes. 6% per annum into we will multiply with 1 by 12 in product method. Very simple. 3 lakh multiply by 6%, 18,000 divide by 12, 1500 is the interest on drawing of Kanika. This is product method. Product method will be used when time interval is not uniform and amount is also not uniform. Any doubt in this method? Interest on drawing? Any question? No? So I hope it is clear. We have computed for Kanika. Now we need to compute for Gautam. Yes.
Sir, this interest is for 1 month or?
No, this is not for 1 month. This interest is for 12, 10, 22, 22 plus 9, 31 month. This 31 is multiplied with the amount. Okay. And this 31 is included in 3 lakh. So this 31 is included in 3 lakh. That's why we have divided by 12. Not for 1 month. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. That's why. So let's calculate for interest on drawing of Gautam's. Gautam's interest on drawing. See, in the question, Gautam withdrew 15,000 on first day of April, July, October, January. So it means for beginning of each and every quarter. 15,000 on first day, okay. So 15,000 into 4, 60,000 multiply by rate of interest on drawing is 6%, multiply by, if he is withdrawing in the beginning of each and every quarter, what is the period which will come? 7.5 by 12, yes or no? Huh? Time left after first quarter, 12 month. Time left after last quarter, 3 month. Divide by 2, in this manner 7.5 month will come. A small working note. So let's calculate here. 60,000, 6%, 7.5 divided by
2250.
Yes, 2250. But some other information is also given, na? That he also paid 20,000 per month as rent for office of partnership. No, this is not drawing. Yes. Suppose if rent is paid for personal, then it will be treated as okay. So I think interest on drawing by product method and by this average period basis method, both are clear to everyone. I hope it is clear.
Yes,